It makes me smile every time I hear a 2D artist say they want to give 3D a go. And when they say this, they're usually talking about converting their self-drawn character to 3D. Unfortunately, some gave up when they're unable to bring their concept character into 3D because of the reasons I shall address here. If you're one of them, then I'm making this video to tell you you don't have to give up. Most of you are only one step amiss. Your drawing skills are probably okay. You don't have to be Michelangelo. You just need to be especially careful with two things: alignment and depth. If you take note to pay attention to these two things, I'm telling you, you will be able to bring your self-drawn character into the 3D world with no problem. To illustrate that, I'm going to go extreme in this video. I will teach you how to create a concept character that will definitely be translatable into 3D, so get your pen and scanner ready, because you will be using your own character and this time it will work. If you are an existing competent 3D artist, you will probably find this way of doing concept art a little on the extreme side. Please understand that I'm here to help those who are really struggling to get their drawings off 2D into 3D to the point of nearly giving up. Start out by drawing the front of your character. Here I'm exploring how the exterior shape will look like without drawing the features in. Initially, I was drawing circles to help as a guide, you know, the fundamentals. But after a while, I just stopped using it as I find it sort of restricts me and I want to be free to explore, as I'm aiming for a childlike character and I pretty much already know what shape I'm after. Eventually, I arrived at the shape that I want. Now, ready for the trick? I can guarantee at least one of you have not heard of this trick, for nobody ever told me this and I have to figure this out for myself. Make a few copies of the front view with guidelines and start drawing the top view of your head. Wait, what? Top view? I thought we are supposed to be drawing the profile of the head. Nope, and that is the reason why your drawing fails to translate into 3D. The curvature of the front of the face is extremely important. If you have the chance to observe faces from the top, you will realize that some people have flatter faces while others have rounder faces. I bet some of you never truly speculated how your character looks like from the top view, isn't it? That's the issue. Some of you never address the frontal curvature. Having to draw the top view forces you to have to think about it, and things are going to be easier for you now because of it. Addressing this view automatically solves two very major issues: the frontal curvature and the depth of the head, also known as how far back the head goes. The number one giveaway of a beginner artist is that they almost never account for the back of the head. They almost never give enough depth. By focusing how right the top of the head looks, these two issues are automatically resolved. It's almost like magic. I remember when I first figured this out, I was like, why didn't anybody tell me this? This solves two of the most major problems in 3D head construction. Unbelievable. I tried out a couple of profile features to see which one is to my liking, and then drew out the front features, lining them up. I love the fact that I get to show you all this process. Usually people would just look at my final schematic and say, I can't do it. No, I cannot do it. Look at the amount of tries I have to go through to get the look that I really want. It's not magic, it just takes time. You can do it too, trust me. I'm no pro, so you know, if I can do it, you can do it too. Now do it for your own drawing, and when you then use your drawing as a front, side, and top reference plane during modeling, I can guarantee you this time, you won't even have to struggle and be puzzled by your own drawing during modeling. It will work this time. Now you can just focus on the technicalities of modeling, like topologies and edge loops. In the second part of this series sometime next week, I'll be talking about the process of converting your 2D character head into 3D, using an amazing program that almost nobody knows by virtue of the fact that that miraculous 3D sketching program is seemingly abandoned. Please support my Patreon. I need your help, guys. I lost my job due to the current situation. I will see you all next week, where I will be focusing on converting your 2D drawing into 3D. This is Brazil Jack, signing off.